And Mike, just again, talking about the what I wish I knew, if you've done 20 odd years, if you like, as that interface and support, and you've met many, many clients and many, many potential candidates. And let's just put the candidate hat on now. You know, what I wish I knew, what kind of top tips, you know, maybe 3, 5, maybe more, but what would you do if you were in a role where you were approached, or if you were in a role where you were interested in getting out there, whether it's UK or internationally? What's your kind of key learnings there?
I think if you're making an approach to somebody who isn't looking for a job, and you start off that dialogue with them, and some people will say, I'm not looking for a job. I'm not interested in talking. And I think my advice to anybody who gets a phone call from a recruiter is to have the conversation with them. Because it's a 5 or 10 minute initial conversation. And be open-minded to those conversations, because you never know if this is going to present you with the best opportunity. So, you know, have that conversation. If you don't, after that conversation, if you don't think it's right, that's absolutely fine. And I speak to people day in, day out, every day of the week. And the majority of the people I speak to are open-minded enough to have that conversation. And sometimes you have that conversation and I will turn around and say, no, I don't think this is the right job for you. And it's, you know, you cannot force somebody into a position if it's not the right thing for them. And I think it's, you don't just pick up the phone to someone and say, you know, are you looking for a job? I've got a great job for you. It's that gentle coercion, that gentle persuasion, that sharing and drip feeding of information, maybe over 2 or 3 phone calls, to get somebody to a point where they're saying, yeah, actually, that actually could be interesting. I like the sound of this. And I think that in some instances is, you know, we work on several projects that are, for whatever reason, extremely confidential. And so you're not able, on those initial conversations, to divulge who you're working for. So you're speaking on behalf of a global organization that is looking to hire whatever the role may be. And candidates always want to know, who you're working for, who's your client. Well, I can't actually tell you. So that's a difficult conversation to have. But I think most people appreciate that. But being open-minded and being willing to have those conversations with people, and even if they don't go anywhere, it's another point of contact that you've established, if not for now, for future reference. So I think key is be open-minded and have those conversations, yeah?